So lately I have been huge into thrifting. I don't know, you just save money. It's a more sustainable approach and you get unique things. I'm kind of over the copy and paste style of the world that we live in. So it's fun. It's like a game trying to find different unique things. So I'm going to show you. I got some fall stuff. First thing is, oh, it's inside out. It's this like a little granny vest that has like a little checkered pattern, and it's knit and just so cozy, and I just love it. That's the first thing. Second thing, I'm loving the fall vibes. Fall is my favorite season to dress for. I got this cable knit brown sweater. I always go in the men's section. They have the best sweaters. And I love this like small little detailing of the light brown. And then cute little logo. Very, very nice. Then more knits. Another just like pattern knit from the men's knit section. And I got this little like tank top vest type thing. I thought I could wear this over like a white t-shirt. That would look super cute. And then I bought this, but I shrunk it. I didn't realize it was real wool, but I still think it'll be cute. I love the color. Little details, cable knit details. This was for sure owned by a grandma, but that's okay. We love the grandma vibes. And speaking of grandma, I bought this cardigan, which is like very grandma-y. I'm not sure how I'm gonna style it, but I just love the pattern. This one I love. Also just a little cardigan that has really just like, it's kind of see-through-ish. And I love this little cut-out detail on the side. And then this shirt, like, I'm pretty sure wasn't even worn. It's from Dynamite. But I just love the pattern on it, and it's a really nice fit. The sleeves, and I love the floral pattern on it. Next, I got this. I honestly haven't tried this one on yet, but I don't really have that many like fancy shirts, so I thought this one would be perfect. I got this. I also don't think this one was ever worn. Just a nice blue vest. I love that color. And then last but not least, this one's super cool and a rare find. But it's this like Fila vest. It has like two tones, which I think is so cool. And what's even cooler about this one is that it's a jacket too, and you just zip the sleeves on, or you can zip them off and wear it as a vest. And I just think that's the coolest thing. Or if you were feeling really fun, you could put the pink on this side and the brown on this side, and it's just like block colors. Okay, this is a struggle, but you get the point. I just think it's so cool. But that's the end of my haul. Hope you liked it, and hope this inspires you to thrift more, because it's fun. You do have to be in the mood. I have to be in the mood, and I need to have patience. But if I make it like a little event, go get a coffee, do some shopping, it's super fun. So I'm gonna go to my parents. I have some paintings I need to get started on, and I have to do some contract work for the agency that I work for, and also finish my website.
We saw birth and death. Can we be still? What makes you kind? From where comes your sparkling mind.
Okay, so I just got to my parents' house, made myself a little coffee. Whenever I get here, I go straight to their fridge or make myself a coffee because parents just have the best food, best coffee, best everything. My parents live a little bit outside of the city, and so it's a very like suburby kind of in nature, and it's just so beautiful, and I just love it more and more as I get older. That's something that I am really finding myself just, I guess, kind of changing in, or it's always been in like my innermost being, is that I am like a country suburb girl at heart. I grew up on an acreage. Well, I guess, so half of my childhood, I was like in the suburbs of Calgary. And then the rest of my childhood, we lived on an acreage. And I think the combination of those two has really like played a role into what I love in a lifestyle. But as I get older and just kind of like turn away from hustle, busy city culture, that is, I think cities are also really cool, but it's just my being just like longs for peaceful nature. Like, I want a garden one day. I want to be able to have my own kitchen and cook and grow my own vegetables and have a little chicken coop, even though chickens are gross, but just, you know, like more homegrown. And I just love like the warmth and coziness about that. So yes, I more and more I'm just like, give it. That's what I want. That's my goals. That's what I'm working towards. I'm gonna have an acreage one day and it's gonna be the best thing ever. Also, it's fall here, and fall in Calgary only lasts for like literally 2 weeks, and so you really have to make the most of it. So I'm gonna go on a little walk because it's beautiful. I'll take you along with my coffee. I have a little podcast. I'm listening to, what is it called? How to Strengthen Your Work. And, okay, the title is taking forever. It's basically how to strengthen your artwork with this lady named Penny Lane, and she's like an art consultant. And she just has a lot of good things to say. So listening to her. And then also another podcast that I found yesterday that is pretty new and I relate with so much. Her name is Paige Lorenz, and her podcast is called Page by Page. But she also is like a city girl who's like going back to her homegrown roots of just suburb country life, and I just love it so much. I relate so much. So I'll link them in the description so you can listen to those.
From where comes your sparkling mind? Was it under the earth?
On my walk, it is very bright out, which means the sun is shining and I have no complaints. But this is where my parents live. This is the walk and the views. It's just so beautiful. Okay, I am at my little makeshift studio at my parents' house. This is where I come one day. I have a goal to have a studio, but for now you make use with what you have. So I am working on a commission for this girl named Nicole. She lives in LA. Okay, so I have just finished the first markings for Nicole's piece, and I'm so excited about this piece because I did a little bit of a different technique, actually quite a lot of a different technique, but I'm really loving how it turned out. It's still abstract, still has my watercolor markings, but this one looks a little different and I'm so excited to show you. These are the markings. They're more like scribbles, lines, but as you can see here, it has more of my watercolor markings right here, right there. even this line right here is pretty watercolored down, but it's just the way that I did it is different, and I am so excited to see this one framed. Okay, so I am just outside of RBC. Finally, I am getting my business credit card. I filled out a form and did the whole application process in July, and it's now September, and it was just kind of a gong show. I think they sent out my card and it got lost, and then they sent it again, and then it got lost again, but now it's finally here, so I'm gonna go pick it up, which is really helpful because then I can start getting all of my business expenses in order under one card, because that is the most important thing when starting out a business, so I've heard, and it makes sense that you have all of your business stuff separated from your personal banking so that it's easy at the end of the year when you can just go through your business section and then your personal. So I'm excited about that. Another thing done for my small business. Okay, so I just stopped at Value Village and I found some really nice frames. I'll show them to you. They're like gold plated on the side, and I'm gonna play around and do some art in there and then potentially sell them. Those are the frames. You can kind of see them. Hi, Maya. Oh, you ready to play? Okay, so this is one of the paintings that I'm framing. Maya is not included, sorry. And then I have four more from the blue collection, and then they'll all be done and they'll be up for sale.